Don't know how many minutes are left in the camera. It might not be enough. Now I made, 23 minutes, that's good. I made a video just yesterday for YouTube of the Sharp Educator model RD-670AV cassette recorder. And I used my lower quality Sony CyberShot camera, which you can barely see right over there. So I'm going to do a demonstration using the better quality camera. So, like in the first video, I'll start out by showing how it records music. Strong amplifier on it. It'd be nice if I had a camera like John Clark's, where it has a thing where once the level is set, it doesn't change, because then I could have a lower level, you could turn the volume up, and then you could hear more realistically how loud it goes. Because automatic level control equipped cameras do not show a good representation of how loud something goes. But anyway, has automatic level control and manual. PA on and off, just using it as a public address system. I need to get my tape. Got my tape here, and my jack equipped microphone.
9 volts my friend gave me,
Okay. Now, of course, if we try to use a built-in mic, if you saw the other video, you'll know this has bad chilling in it, and it will have a hum. So I have to use an external one. I'm now using an external microphone with the recorder here. Watch the VU meter go. And I can yell, or somewhat yell. And as you can see, the automatic level control works pretty well. Manual. Manual level control. I'm going to pause the camera. Rewind. Play.
Please, for me.
Now using an external microphone with the recorder here. Watch the VU meter go. And I can yell, or somewhat yell. As you can see, the automatic level control works pretty well. Manual level control, I'm going to pause the camera. Now, set the level higher. The level is all the way up, and of course now it's somewhat sensitive to sound. Yes, somewhat sensitive. It's not super duper sensitive, but it's not hotly sensitive either. It's kind of in between. I'm speaking at arm's length distance. Now I'm sure if I used a high impedance microphone, the sensitivity would be a lot greater. So I'm going to pause. I'm going to switch over to a high impedance Akai microphone. Right now I'm using a Sony microphone. A little disappointing, this microphone isn't as sensitive on this recorder as I thought it would be. Anyway, we can still hear if there's a difference in the sound quality with this old Akai microphone, which came with my Akai M5 that I got back in September of 2005. By the way, the Akai microphone and M5 were from 1960. The Sony microphone was my Sony F96, which is probably from the mid to semi-late 60s. Like, probably like 1966, 67, something like that. Now my disappointment with this recorder. My disappointment with this recorder is, even though it is AC biased, there seems to be an awful lot of hiss in the recordings. You may have noticed, it seems to kind of have a lot of, just a lot of noise in the recordings, or something like that. But other than that, it's good. But now I want to show you the neat thing on here. There's a more basic model of this. Speaker Freak had one up for sale. It was like this, but it was the basic model. It didn't have any slide projector controls, just the tape recorder. But this one has slide projector controls. You got sync mode, you got impose, which I'm not sure what that does. I tried fiddling with it. It didn't seem to really do anything on impose. And then it's got separate. And you got a button for sync recording. You have a button for a 1 kilohertz tone. I'm very glad they actually labeled the frequencies their tones are, instead of just saying like slide and stop or something. It's just 1 kilohertz tone and a 150 hertz tone. And then restart. First, we're going to make a recording. Get a microphone again, just for talking guide and all that kind of stuff. We got the machine started and record. Now let's turn on sync record. You can see the LED lights up. Now I believe you can run sync record even when the machine's in play mode. So you can add sync tones to a previously recorded tape. Now these sync tones are actually recorded on the other side of the tape. So you can only have a side A if you use a sync tape. Now I'm going to insert a 1 kHz tone. And you can hear a relay activate. Listen carefully. And now I'm going to insert a 150 hertz tone. Two of them, actually. You can hear a separate relay operate as well. Now, if the 150 hertz, the 150 hertz can be switched to stop or sync. This has two projector outputs, as you may have noticed earlier when I showed the close-up of the left side of the machine. You can actually run two separate projectors on it independently. If it's set to sync, a 150 hertz tone will trigger the second projector, while the 1 kilohertz tone will trigger the first projector. When it's set to stop, the 1 kilohertz tone will control the projector as normal, and the 150 hertz tone will tell the tape to stop. Then, of course, you'd use your restart button to start the tape back up again. You can also use the sync input and sync output to use the audio track used by the synchronizer. You don't have to put in tones to try to control projectors or whatever. If you want, you can actually put line level audio or other line level source into the sync in, and it will record when this is in record mode in onto the sync track, and then the sync out will play back line level playback signal when it's in playback, and it will play the second track, so you can actually hear the tones. You may have saw a video called Tape and Slow Scan TV, and I used this recorder, and I had put Slow Scan TV on the synchronized in and recorded it to have illustrations to go with talk that I had on the tape, and then the sync out I would put onto the computer, and when I'd play it back, the other side of the tape, the sync track, would have the Slow Scan TV, which would go to provide an illustration to the speech that was on the normal side of the tape. So now let's go and play this back. We want our sync mode on separate. Turn on sync record. You can see the LED lights up. Now I believe you can run sync record even when the machine's in play mode. So you can... Now I want to give a visual display on the switches for the projectors actually operating. So I'm going to hook up a battery and a light bulb to the projector part so you can actually see it work, because I don't have a projector cord for it. Okay.
Toned to a previously recorded tape. Now these sync tones are actually recorded on the other side of the tape, so you can only have a side A if you use a sync tape. Now I'm going to insert a 1 kilohertz tone, and you can hear a relay activate. Listen carefully. And now I'm going to insert a 150 hertz tone.
And the tape stopped, so I have to press restart.
Two of them, actually. You can hear a separate relay operate as well.
Now let's hook it up to the other projector output and set it to sync, the 150 hertz, to now control the bulb.
And now I'm going to insert a 150 hertz tone. Two of them, actually. You can hear a separate relay operate as well. Now, if the 150 hertz, the 150 hertz can be switched to stop or sync. This has two projector outputs, as you may have noticed earlier when I showed the close-up of the left side of the machine. You can actually run two separate projectors on it independently. If it's set to sync, the 150 hertz tone will trigger the second projector, while the 1 kilohertz tone will trigger the first projector. The 150 hertz tone will trigger the second projector, while the 1 kilohertz tone will trigger the
And of course we want to put this on projector 1 now. I only have one of these plugs, that's why I'm not running two bulbs. Otherwise I'd be running two bulbs.
For the second projector, while the 1 kilohertz tone will trigger the first projector. When it's set to stop, the 1 kilohertz tone will control the projector as normal, and the 150 hertz tone will trigger the projector. When it's set to stop, the 1 kilohertz tone will control the projector as normal, and the 1 hertz tone will tell the tape to stop. Then of course you'd use your restart button to start the tape back up again.
Now let's turn the tape over and listen for the actual tones. Just some kind of classic feeling one gets hearing that from a tape. Something about that old school audio-visual feel that just feels good. It's just neat. My camera light is still on. I wanted that off. There. You can barely see the speaker grill. That's how bad my lighting is in here. It's viewable just fine in real life, but on the camera it's just, you know. Yeah, is that a little better? Well, I got the camera light on again. But it's very neat. It's a very nice recorder. One thing I don't like about it is that they didn't do a better, they didn't do a lower noise floor on the recording. They could have made it have a lot less background noise. Notice there was quite a lot of hiss on the thing. But other than that, it's a neat old machine. It actually does great for...